Hello guys, today I am going to teach you about the male reproductive system. See, in male reproductive organ, there are two parts. First one is the external genital organ, second one is the internal genital organ. What is external genital organ? The organ which are the outside of the body, that is the external genital organ. And the organ inside of the body related to reproduction, that is the internal genital organ. Now, which are the external genital organ? See in figure, there is two external genital organ. First one is a penis and second one is a scrotum. Now, which are the internal genital organs? First one is a testis, which is located inside of the scrotum. Then upper side of the testis, there is epididymis, then vas deferens, then three accessory glands which is very helpful for the production of the semen and development of the semen. There is a seminal vesicle, prostate gland and bulbourethral glands. So these are the internal genital organ and these are the external genital organs. Now we are moving towards the next slide. First one is a external genital organ, that is the penis, and second one is a scrotum. Here you can see in figure both organ are, you can see. Now we are moving towards the next slide. Now we'll see regarding the penis. First we will see the introduction of the penis. It is a tube like structure which is hanged outside of the body. It is a tube like structure and hang outside of the body. Second one is it is a male sex organ reaching its full size during the puberty. It is the organ related to sexual organ, which is related to reproduction, and it reach full size during the puberty. Next point is, in addition to its sexual function, the penis act as a conduit for the urine to leave the body. Apart from the sexual function, there is another function of the penis is to conduit the urine from the body to the outside. So, next point is, the penis is the organ by which the sperm is introduced into the female. Also, the ejaculation function, the ejaculation of semen or sperm into the vagina of the female. This is the second function. First one is to conduit the urine from the body to the outside. And second one is to ejaculate sperm into the female. It contains spongy tissue that becomes turgid and erect when filled with the blood. Okay, it has a spongy tissue, but it becomes turgid when it is erect. So this is the introduction of the penis. So it is a tube-like structure, hang outside of the body. It is a male sex organ. When it will become mature at the time of the puberty, there is two functions. One is a sexual function and second one is to conduit the urine from the body. And second one is to ejaculate sperm into the vagina of the female. And it is a spongy, it has a spongy tissue as well as it become turgid and when the erect. Now we are moving towards the next slide. Now we are moving towards the glands. What is glands? Glands is a head of the penis. It is rounded in shape and it is a head of the penis. As its tip is expanded into a triangular structure, which is known as a glans penis. It is rounded and highly sensitive head of the penis, because sensory nerve supplies are more in the glands. So this is the glands of the penis. This is the tip of the penis. It is rounded and highly sensitive area of the penis, and this is the first part of penis. Now we are moving towards the next slide. Then the foreskin. After the glands, there is a foreskin. Foreskin is a fold of skin covering the head of the penis. See in figure. It is a movable double layer, and in circumcised men, the foreskin is surgically removed and the mucosa of the glands transform into the dry skin. You already know, mostly Muslim people are doing circumcision. Why? Because they are believing that the dry skin is necessary to prevent the further disease related to the penis. So when in circumcised man the foreskin is surgically removed, the foreskin, we can say that is the prepuce, it is surgically removed, and mucosa on the glands which is transferred as a dry skin. Now the urethra is a tube like structure within the penis that conveys semen out of the body during the ejaculation as well as urine from the bladder to the outside of the body. So this is the urethra. Now we are going to next slide. There is two erectile tissue. First one is a corpus spongiosum and second one is a corpus cavernosa. Corpus spongiosum is surrounding the area of the urethra, and corpus cavernosa is around the area of the corpus spongiosum. Okay, corpus spongiosum is the mass of spongy tissue which surround the urethra and involve, what is the main function? It involves in erection by allowing rushing of blood into it. It causes the erection. Second one is a corpus cavernosa. It is one of a pair of the sponge-like region. It is also sponge-like region of the erectile tissue, which contain most of the blood in penis during the penile erection. Okay, so this is the two area of the two covering of the penis: corpus spongiosum and corpus cavernosum. So understood? Now we are moving towards the next slide. An erection results from changes in blood flow in the penis. Erection is occur due to the change of the blood flow into the penis. When a man becomes sexually aroused, the nerve causes penis blood vessel to be expand. Okay, when man becomes very sexually aroused, at that time nerve causes the penis blood vessel to dilate. More blood flows in and less flows out of the penis. Okay, at that time more blood flows in, they fill by the blood, and less flows out of the penis. So there will be a storage of the blood, hardening of the tissue in the corpus cavernosum. Okay, at that time hardening of the tissue occur in the corpus cavernosum. Now we are moving towards the next slide. Now which are the blood supply of the penis? First one is arterial blood supply and second is a venous release. Which is the artery related to the penis? See in figure, there is a bulbar arteries of the penis from the branch, which is a branch from the internal pudendal artery, and urethral artery. Second one is a venous drainage. Venous drainage is from the internal pudendal and internal iliac vein. So these are the blood supply of the penis. Now we are moving towards the next slide. Now the nerve supply. The nerve supply of the penis is autonomic and somatic nerves. Parasympathetic stimulation leads to filling of the spongy erectile tissue with blood caused by the arteriolar dilatation and venoconstriction. The blood fills with the, at that time artery will be dilate and vein will be constricted. So blood filling will be done by that time due to the parasympathetic nerve stimulation. Now, which increase blood flow into the penis and obstruct the outflow? So blood can goes inside of the penis and it can't be go outside of the penis. So obstruction will be there. The penis therefore becomes engorged and erect, essential for the sexual intercourse. So this is the nerve supply. This is the very important. It is different from the other organ. So which nerve is there? Dorsal nerve and autonomic and sympathetic nerves. Now we will learn regarding the scrotum. Scrotum is a pouch of the skin formed from the lower part of the abdominal wall. It is a pouch of the skin formed from the lower part of the abdominal wall. It is a deeply pigmented skin, fibrous and connective tissue and smooth muscles are there. The scrotum keeps the testes at a temperature slightly cooler than the body temperature. Now, the location of the scrotum. It lies below the symphysis pubis and in front of the upper part of the thighs and behind the penis. Where it is located? Below the symphysis pubis, upper part of the thighs and behind the penis. Now, it is divided into two compartments, each of which contain, it has a two compartment, it is divided into two compartments. Each compartment contains one testis, one epididymis, and the testicular end of spermatic cord. Now, scrotum contains blood supply. So, in arterial supply, which artery is there? Anterior scrotal artery and external pudendal artery. Second is a posterior scrotal artery, that is a branch from the internal pudendal artery. Two arterial supply, anterior and posterior scrotal artery. Okay. What about the venous drainage? That is the scrotal veins follow the major arteries draining into the external pudendal veins. Now which are the nerve supplies? That is the genital branch of the genitofemoral nerves, anterior and posterior scrotal nerves, and perineal branches of posterior femoral cutaneous nerve. So these are the three nerve supplies to the scrotum. So this is the blood supply of the scrotum. Now if you have any query, you can ask me, and if you have any problem or any doubts, you can ask me. Thank you. Hello guys, I have made video for you. This is the educational video as a part of anatomy and physiology. If you like my video, then please subscribe my channel and like the video. Thank you.